Good morning from Panhandle Outdoors, America's only daily outdoor TV show. Your source for fishing, hunting, and information for folks who enjoy the great outdoors. Now sit back, relax. It's Panhandle Outdoors.
Good morning, folks. Welcome to Panhandle Outdoors. Welcome to Friday morning's edition. We have all kind of cool stuff going on. I hope you're getting to enjoy that full moon last night, and it's also been real lit up tonight. So it's been a pretty couple of nights we've had. I've just went outside, just looked at it. I've been in awe of it since I was about that high, as I know you have. All right, let's move on with our weather. Brought to us by Gulf Coast Air Conditioning, Drew Pollard and his hardworking crew, taking care of our everyday comfort needs. Highs getting all the way up to 81 today, but low will be 65 at night. And I was thinking how, reflecting about these springtime nights or just generally cool in the mornings, early in the mornings, it's just that coolness. And it's really an enjoyable time. You don't want to get out on the water though too early without any kind of windbreak or something on. These little things, I don't know if you think of these things like I do, but I often do when I get outside. Our river reading is brought to us by our friends down at Panama City Coca-Cola. Good folks down there. We're looking at the Apalachicola Bluntstown. It's funny, it stayed like this all week long. It's just steady. It's not moving much. It's reading this morning at 8.5. And the shock test at Caraville, this is reflective of what it's done the last 3 or 4 days. Just a slow, steady drop reading this morning at a 5.7 at Caraville. Our tide chart brought to us by Kent Forest Lawn. Not better tide today than yesterday. Going to be a better tide tomorrow. Looking at a high tide this morning about 9:30. And a low tide tonight about 7:35. Our wind direction will be coming south-southeast, and you guessed it, at about 12. Now, let's go into our fishing game times today, brought to us by Blue Water Outriggers. We're looking at their time today, again, one more time, 11:39 to 1:39. And oftentimes when we have a new moon or full moon, we just get that one feeding time. It's been interesting to watch that over the years. Let's take a break, I'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. Let's take a look at our schedule. We'll keep everything straight as what's coming up in the outdoors. Springtime in the Florida Panhandle is very active when we start doing outdoor things ourselves personally and other folks doing all kinds of things. So remember tomorrow now will be, actually tonight, they're having a captain's meeting for the Swivel Sisters Bayou Bash. It will be, the weigh-in will start tomorrow around 3 o'clock. The Swivel Sisters, we had Kendra on the show and several of them, the Bayou Bash 2023, they're going to have some things that you can, some raffle tickets you can buy. You don't just have to necessarily be in a tournament to win anything, okay? And also, it'll be good food. And again, this fundraiser, it goes toward these kids getting scholarships and all. We're having some technical difficulty. But we'll get it straightened out. But we'll move along, we'll get it working out. I don't know what the problem is, Jeff, but okay. And the next thing we got coming up will be the...
Good.
Okay, we're good now. Here we go, thank you. All right, here we go. We got a Swivel Sister. We got it up there. The Bayou Bash 2023. All right. And then, okay, the next item, okay, mention this, Saturday, May 27th, which is a couple of weeks, down at Halber Creek, the Brim Fishing Tournament. And we've talked about that. We just want to remind everybody, just put it on the calendar. I just mentioned all this stuff to put it on the calendar. And then also, we talked about this yesterday, on the next weekend, June the 3rd, will be the Taunton Family Festival, okay? So it's not on there either, is it? What do you think's wrong this morning? Okay, so we got... All right, we just have to wing it, I think. So anyway, well, I have some pictures and all, so let me move on to... One thing I wanted to discuss with you and to tell you about was I don't know if you saw where the legislation in the Oregon House and Senate on the floor... They presented a bill that would actually outlaw hunting and fishing in the state of Oregon. Now they don't think it's going to pass, but for it to be even to be discussed and talked about in a state senate or house in America is just spooky. Okay, so anyway, you be aware of that. Also, if you have an opportunity to just do things positive for people, as far as when you go around and talking about outdoor stuff and all, we want to make sure we do some positive thinking about them. I had all kind of pictures set up and all, and we're unable to connect. So we're having some awful difficulties and all. So we're going to move on and do the best we can with what we got. I was going to talk about Mother's Day. Mother's Day is coming up, and it's not this Sunday, the following Sunday. And we always try to get stuff together for the Mother's Day, really the outdoor ladies, but all mothers. And they don't necessarily have to be outdoor lovers, but they can just enjoy some parts of the outdoors. So, in fact, I had Gail help me last night to write some things down, and I said, help me on this. I need the top 10 list for Mother's Day. And one of the first things she said was, how about a rocking lawn chair? And we've had a situation where the rocking lawn chair has really come in handy. We go to all kind of ball games and everything, or different outdoor activities, and the technology in these lawn chairs has just been amazing. So that's one, a rocking lawn chair. And number two, with summer coming up and snorkeling, all kind of things, and scallop season coming up in August, how about a new mask fin and snorkel? That's always something good. Technology has improved on it so much. Number three, and this is a good one, a bicycle. A good, safe bicycle, and especially if you live in an area where you can ride around a couple blocks and all, a bicycle is great exercise, but I still ride my bicycle. It's exhilarating. I mean, I feel sometimes I get out there out in the neighborhood and I feel like I'm a kid again, and riding through and just pedal, and looking around and seeing what's going on, and it's just a lot of fun. So anyway, I'm going to take a break now and see if we can get it straight, and then we'll come back and finish up on this. So we'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. We got it working right now. We're going to have to use my phone, but same thing. So here we go. We got to talk about coming up next week, real big sale at Blue Water Outriggers, okay? Bobby sent this to me. All right, here's the sale starts. This is Bobby Scarborough, store manager. Sale starts May 10th at 6 a.m. and runs through close of business May 23rd. There will be big savings throughout the store, and especially in fishing and tackle products. So we want all of our Panhandle Outdoor viewers to know about this and take advantage of it, okay? So that's going to be important. There's the Taunton Family Children's Home. Now, the other pictures I wanted to show you, let's see. We want to, right here, we need to be reminded. Every year I need to be reminded again and again. This time of year now, it's really coming out. And to tell the difference between poison ivy, there's poison ivy on the left there, poison oak, and poison sumac. And that both, all three of them are just, really irritating and get all over you, but especially the poison ivy. If you see that, stay away from it. It can really make a mess. Paul Thrasher, he watches the show, good outdoorsman. He, this is called a big old good'un. And he went back. And this is interesting because a lot of folks now, even in fresh water, are releasing these big old brim. Honestly, they've never have been that good to eat. The smaller ones always been taste better. And these big ones, and Paul doing the same thing. Big ones are just, a lot of folks are releasing them. This is special to me. We had Mandy on yesterday, and I wanted to show this. Okay, I want you to look at the date. This is Miller Marine. Mandy posted this back in April of 2018, and she just went along talking about how her family have this family heritage in the last sentence. My sister and I have some mighty big shoes to fill, because it goes back to Joe Ed, Duck, and Grover, and Captain Davis, and all that. So what happened, all three of these boats were brought into their shipyard, not on purpose at the same time, but they all ended up there at the same time. This is a Queen fleet, okay? There's the Ocean Queen, okay? And one of my favorite, the old Florida Queen. I love that boat, love fishing off that boat. And the Star Queen, how many trips do those boats take? Look at the old truck over there. Okay, so Mandy posted this in April. Little did she realize, or did any of us realize, what's going to happen the following, on October the 18th, a couple of months later. Here they are, out in front of Grover Davis's house, total from Hurricane Michael. Isn't that ironic that she, we after got those pictures, they were all in the boatyard together at the same time, and they're wrecked right there, and our history is gone on those Queen Fleet boats. Maybe one day they can do a reproduction or something. I just wondered, that just really hit me yesterday about when I had Mandy on, I was driving home, I was thinking about all the boats they had and how important they all were. Now, I do want to share this with you. At times, I get an opportunity to, and this has nothing to do, well, it does have something to do with outdoor, because I get to speak to the outdoor seniors. I've done that a long time, and even when I retired, I would go back and give them a little motivational talk. And so I was up there the other day, and I got a couple of pictures to show you. Here we are up here. This is most of the kids sitting in the back, okay? But I just showing some pictures. But I have this little thing here. You may appreciate this. These are bricks right here. And on the right, those old broken bricks are bad things, and on the left are good things. And I tell the kids about those things. And then I've got this little doll, and if I put them over this stuff on the right, all the broken bricks, it won't stand up. But if you put them on these good bricks with compassion, hope, love, service, prayer, respect, faith, and friendship, it can stand up by itself. And they get a kick out of that because it falls over on all the right stuff, but on the left stuff. So anyway, that's part of my motivational speech that I give to them. And, you know, it's hard to get seniors the last month of school, their senior year, motivated at anything. They're ready to get out of there. And they felt like, but it goes over real well. I feel really good about it, and I just thankful I can still do that and reach some of those kids. I just want to share that with you, and that's what I was talking about earlier in the other segment. If you get a chance to do some good things and share good things with people, go ahead and do that. Okay, let's finish up on the Mother's Day real quick. Third one was bicycle. The fourth one, Gail came up with this one: a new sun hat, a beach bag, and a towel and flip-flops, like a little package of stuff. I thought it was a pretty good idea. I wouldn't have thought about that. Then I came up with this one. How about a new kayak or paddleboard? Go down to Sunjammer and see. They've got all kind of cool stuff at Sunjammer's. And that's not a bad idea now. Six is sunglasses. I don't think you can ever have enough sunglasses, because if you're like me, you're going to lose them or crack them or something. Number seven, a cornhole game. That's a good outdoor activity. You get outdoors and it's a lot of fun. It just swept across the nation years ago, not, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago, and I don't know how long ago it was, but anyway, young people just start loving doing it, and it's really a fun game to play, cornhole. Plus, you can take the frame right there and you can paint it and actually customize it. You can put your name on it or paint all kind of stuff. We let the kids make ours. Number eight, a ladies' lightweight bow. Go down to C&G, get Mark to fit you out with a lightweight bow, and just do that. That's a lot of fun. You can do a little bit of target practicing and just get out in the woods and do some things. That's a good idea. And number nine, this is always good: a fishing trip with your inshore fishing guides. We'll talk about having the good ones we have here, so you get a chance to just get them a certificate. And you can go along too and take pictures, but just ladies' fishing trip. Or they might want to take some friends with them. And that was number nine. And if all else fails, number 10, gift certificates. I've changed my mind over the years on gift certificates. They're good ideas. They really are. I used to not like to give them. I enjoy giving them now, especially to a store that they're going to really enjoy going in and shopping. Okay, so that's a Mother's Day for next week. You got all week to get ready now. You got this weekend too. All right, now let's get ready for our giveaway. We've got to ask some names this morning. Michael Harris. I don't know how we miss Michael and Braden. Michael and Braden Harris. And then the dad, Johnny Harris. And mom, Darlene. Okay, the Harris family there in St. Andrew. All right, and then we've got from Malone, Trey McDaniel and Jennifer McDaniel. Now, for some reason, if I haven't put your name in, we had a lot of names that just coming in on a regular basis, and sometimes I think we have them, maybe not. But Gail keeps a master list, so if I haven't put your name in here, please let me know. We'll be glad to get in there. Okay. The $20 gift certificate to Tarpon Dock Seafood is going to, all the way from Panama City Beach, Jay Atkins. All right, Jay. And the Big Red Snapper. Big Red Snapper will be good this weekend. All the way from Youngstown, Edward Kirkland. So Panama City Beach and Youngstown are our winners. Okay, I think they just fell out right there. I won't tell you who it is. All right, we're going to take our final break and come back with our famous Friday fishing forecast. Okay, welcome back. We're going to do our famous Friday fishing forecast sitting down. I did get Google Earth up, and we may get to it or may not, but I've got it written down last night, all the things we want to do. The first thing that over this week, first thing I wrote down was pompano caught on fire this week. I got reports, especially on the west end. For some reason, on the east end, it's been pretty strong, pretty steady. But also on the west end, over toward Navarre and over toward the west end of the beach, they were just boom, boom, boom catching. I mean, it just went through. It started like on Sunday afternoon, Monday and Tuesday especially. There were a lot of pompano being caught. That was interesting. As I followed the reports, I said I knew what was going on. That was a really big school just hitting those areas, a really big school like that, and that's happened before. I've seen it happen to St. George Island like that, and then come on up to toward us up here, Shell Island. So I wrote down pompano, and also, now, you love to surf fish. You need to go and get on out there and make sure you're doing it now. This here it is May, and what's coming up in a couple of weeks will be June, and of course, then comes that June grass, and we know what comes to the June grass. Here comes the catfish. So surf fishing is not all that good in middle June and July and August. I'd never doing it because of those kind of things. On occasion, you get out there and do it, but springtime is to do it, so make sure you do that. Also, the slams, all of my bay system, Choctachy Bay, all the way down to Apalachicola Bay, Oklahoma Bay, here in St. Andrew Bay, make it a goal to get your saltwater inshore slam. And you know what that is. That's a flounder, that's a redfish, and a trout, all caught on the same trip. And what made me think about it, this time of year, it's always good, but you've seen the pictures. I've had three different sets of pictures where people have gotten their inshore slam within the last week and a half. So now's the time to do it. So if you're sort of bored of just regular fishing and want to catch another challenge and catch something cool, work on that slam. Now, going over to freshwater, on the bass fishing, the good news, all kind of good news on bass fishing, it's hot. But the bass fishing club, the not so serious club, that they sort of they got, both of them became new fathers, so they had to take serious actions with their family. So the not so serious Saturday tournaments have been put on hold. But now someone's picked it up; they're going to start back. So we'll get back with them, and let you know what's going on. Also, I thought about last night, frog gigging is right around the corner. I know summertime frog gigging is really interesting to do, but in the springtime, they're out there croaking real loud because they're mating and all. They're just really, the bullfrog is real loud this time of year. The brim fishing has been really good. Okay, so now let's go to some locations. Why don't we start here in the center? We're never starting in the center. How about St. Joe Bay? Again, St. Joe Bay is fishing is steady. It's good and steady, the reports I've gotten. The surf fishing is good, but the bay fishing is real good. Like I say, these channels here around Black's Island, good trout fishing. And the wind has been coming out of the south today, so now it'll be a good time. That runs north and south right there, so you see where it can get over there. Also, the Indian Pass area, let's go to Indian Pass. You can shore fish from it. There's going to be a lot of catfish and all, but you can catch you some flounder coming in and out of there, okay? And backside of St. Vincent Island, now again, a lot of oyster shells in here, a lot of oyster bars, but that means there's a lot of redfish and trout in there, but just know your way around. Moving on down to the East Point area. Bridge fishing is good early in the morning. Remember, I hadn't talked about Old Bridge in quite some time, but they're over there at Cat Point. But that's, again, a good area to go. And over here, St. George Island is a good place to go, right back in here. Especially wade fishing, all wade fishing through here. Now, the state park is good. I'm sort of repeating a lot of other places we've always gone. Real quick, I want to go to on the backside of Dog Island. If you have a boat and come back right here in the center of the screen, right in that area right there, and go work in this direction right here. That's good red fishing. There's some crab traps up there and some triple tail in there. Okay, so be careful of that. Now, let's run way over here to Choctashy Bay. Real quick, Choctashy Bay. I've gotten good reports. The Choctashy River's in really good shape. It's falling out really good. And the Black Creek area, okay, all this area been here. You put in a pine log landing, put it up under the bridge at Ebro, and fish the Choctashy River. You have all kind of little areas in here. It's going to be really good brim fishing all throughout. The East River's been good. Bunker. When I know I don't get a lot of reports from those folks, I know they're biting. And you see how the Choctahatchee River winds through this area. Really unique area. Okay, going over here toward, let's see if we can find Freeport. If you get up here in this bayou, there are a lot of docks being built. Okay, I don't know if you can see them. We can zoom in on the docks. This bayou in here, see all the docks up in there, LaGrange Bayou? That's holding a lot of fish right there. Fishing these docks. You want to come in on a high tide. Okay, then the tide starts going out. And go right out here to mouth, right in this area here. You see how small that mouth is? They all got to come out of that area right there in the center of the screen. Okay, so anyway, all kind of things going on, salt water and fresh water. Got a tournament. I'll see some of y'all tomorrow at the Bayou Bash at Salinas Park right there at the Cape. And if anything going on that you need us to advertise or tell folks about it, you get a hold of us and we'll be sure to do it for your benefit and your club or organization's benefit. Got to wrap it up for the week. Had some good guests. I've enjoyed doing this week and appreciate you watching Panhandle Outdoors. You do something good today for someone else. Have a great weekend. Enjoy the outdoors and God bless.
Thanks for watching America's only daily outdoor TV show, Panhandle Outdoors with Winston Chester, featuring hunting, fishing, and other activities and information to help you enjoy the great outdoors. Join us next time for Panhandle Outdoors.